Hey guys, I'm Voylin and welcome to a new video of GoZen, our video editor made in Godot. And before you get worried, don't worry. There is no coffee making montage coming because this is hot chocolate milk. And also this is basically, I have a migraine again, but I don't have enough time to actually film because my kids for some reason stopped sleeping in the afternoon. So first up, the thing that I want to share with you guys is the GitHub page for GoZen. So this is our GitHub page. I have not updated this in a couple of days yet because I have not had the time to actually do any programming yet. Being a stay-at-home, that can be quite busy. So we have our assets, basically does not have anything useful in it right now. And then the source code together with some other things like a license. The license is actually something I've added after I got a suggestion by somebody, by Wilker Uwe, to include a license. So after looking a little bit, confetti. Okay. After looking around to different licenses, I decided to go for the AGPL license. It is basically GPL, but then with networking stuff included. Something else I've done is add a sponsor this project thing. So people can sponsor me through GitHub itself or through Ko-fi. We have an issues tab. I just added a couple of things here for now. It's still too early in development to actually give like a proper issue tab of like what needs to happen, because right now still everything needs to happen. Something I've also done on the GitHub page is create a discussion section. So we have announcements, a general help, I need somebody, if in case you run into an issue, the ideas tab. Some of these have some information on how to actually like share your ideas, and a tab for sharing your modules. And that's basically all I have on GitHub right now. I will try to upload all the things that I do as pull requests, so everything stays nicely organized. And another thing I've done is I've created a Discord page. Right now, not really anybody is talking in the chat. I have a tab for Voylin's Game Dev Journey, Voylin's Live, my older YouTube channel, Voylin Sensei, my older YouTube channel, and then also a tab for the GoZen video editor, and so far no messages, so let's tap on.
I don't really use Discord, but I know it's kind of popular, so I thought from let's just create it and check it every evening.
Rendering video is not a very easy task, but first a quick explanation of what a video file actually is. A video file is a container, and they can have extensions like .avi, .mp4, .mkv, .mov, .webm, and so on and so on. Inside of these video files, you get the media itself, so the frames of the video, the pictures, as a matter of speaking, and the audio. There's also the metadata, the information of how the video has to be played, and it can also contain other things like subtitles, for example, or multiple languages. Making that kind of a container sounds difficult, but there are quite a few programs like FFmpeg to take all your data to create your video file. So we don't really have to worry about those kind of things, those small little details. Because I'm using Godot, rendering the frames won't be a problem, but it actually is a problem, like a really, really big problem. And the reason why I have been working on this for multiple weeks now. I can easily render each frame of a subviewport with this piece of code. This works great and fast if you save these pictures into a folder and then feed all those pictures into an FFmpeg command, which generates the video itself. Please note that I'm only talking about the visual part of the video, as I haven't gotten around to the audio part yet. But yes, a 10 second video at 30 frames per second gives us around 300 frames, so 300 pictures. For making very short videos, this is probably going to be fine. But videos use something called codecs. We have different codecs like 8.265, 8.264, VP9, AV1, MPEG2, MPEG4, and a couple others. The main goal is to compress all the data so the video does not take up too much storage space. So those 300 frames from before, from a 10 second clip, will take up a lot less data inside of the video itself, compared to having all those frames separately. But here we got our first problem, efficiency. If we always have to save the images first and then use something like FFmpeg to generate the video, we'll be running into two issues, which won't be very noticeable for small videos, but will become a bigger problem for larger videos. Instead of saying what the problem is, here's an example of what would happen. Imagine instead of our 10-second video, we have a 10-minute video. So our 300 frames suddenly become around 18,000 frames. Now imagine that this 10-minute video is in 4K quality. The amount of space required for saving 18,000 frames in 4K quality would consume around 350 gigabytes of data. So our first problem is running out of storage space. For many people, it's probably going to be fine, but for others, 350 gigabytes will take up almost everything that they have. Even if you can save all images, you still need enough space for the video itself, which also gets built afterwards. So taking up even more space before we can finally delete all those frames, all those images. But there's also a second problem, which will be more noticeable for people editing many videos like YouTubers, for example. The constant writing and deleting from your hard drive will degrade the capacity quite quickly, especially if you render out 18,000 4K frames a couple of times a month. Basically writing 350 gigabytes of data every single time when you want to make a video. And that's not even included the final render of the video that also includes audio and such. So we need a more efficient way of actually creating the video by passing the frames in a more efficient way. So Godot can generate the frames and keep them in memory as bytes. So to be more efficient without overusing the hard drive, by example, we can use that data which is saved into the RAM, the random access memory. We can feed that information directly into an ffmpeg command. One way to do this is by passing the bytes of each frame dynamically into an ffmpeg command through something called a pipe. Quick explanation of what a FIFO pipe is. I don't know how you actually pronounce it, but FIFO stands for first in, first out, and it makes certain that ffmpeg or any other command receives all data in the correct order. But this is not possible inside of Godot. We cannot open a pipe inside of Godot. We could create a named pipe and run ffmpeg as a separate process, but Godot still cannot write to the named pipes. So we had to fix this problem. Then I came up with the idea of running a Python script which Godot sends the frames to. And Python handles sending the data to a named pipe. But I could not get this to work at all and lost 1 week of trying. And even when it worked to send data, ffmpeg decided that the video should only be one frame long and closed the process, leaving us with a one frame long video, which is not what we want. So how did I solve this issue? Because I really needed this to work to make the rendering of the video more efficient and actually like make the editor usable for rendering videos. If this would not have been possible, then I could have thrown away the entire project and started all over again or just give up. The way that I fixed this problem is by creating a Python server. Godot starts the script in a separate process, so Python starts running, and then Godot connects to that server and sends the image bytes of each frame. And then the Python server basically does the rest with the ffmpeg stuff. It would probably be better to have this code included inside of the video editor's main code by using GD extensions or something, but for now, this is more than enough. It has been a couple of weeks now. That whole animation bit took a lot longer than I thought it would take. So yeah, that was something. In the meantime, I've been working a little bit on the UI and on the coding itself. There's a reason why I don't show too much code of it yet. It's because it still requires a lot of cleanup work. Still a couple of things, bugs that are happening with the codes to render the videos. But it's almost done and I don't really know how much code I should include in this video, so if you have some kind of suggestion or you want to see more code or you want to see a specific video really going into detail about the code that I have right now, then please let me know. At any moment in time, if you have something you want to see about how I'm making this editor, please share it in the comments of this video or of any video. I'm new to making development logs and I'm not really certain like what to include, what not to include. But it has been kind of busy and that whole video renderer system took a very long time to figure it out. It was quite annoying and I'm so happy that it's finally done and that I was able to render my first video. The video itself is nothing special. It's just a container note moving from one point to another point, but
at least it's a video and I was able to make it. So that's kind of proof that the system that I'm going to use is actually going to be possible. Now, I should probably like try to include that whole renderer part in a GD extension, by example. Will be more performant than it is right now. Like, it's kind of difficult to show a lot of this because a lot of the development is code related and not very UI related. I made a post asking it like what to see next. So far it looks like many people want to see a UI update. That is possible, like the UI updates, like it's getting pretty close to like the final UI for like the first version. The only thing I'm struggling with right now is the doing the timeline stuff. The timeline is probably the most difficult thing to actually like get it working properly. But once that's working and I figured that out, basically it's done. The first version is complete. Except for I still need to figure out audio stuff. That's something I haven't really looked into yet. I can create videos, but at this moment they don't have any sounds. Also, there's no way to have any effects on any video clips yet. But I'm certain as soon as I figure the timeline thing out, that won't be any problem. And before I close this video, I really want to say thank you again to the two people who donated on the Ko-fi page. It really helps a lot, and it really helps a lot for my motivation as well to work even harder on this project. So thank you very much. Thank you very much, and I'll see you all in my next video. Bye bye.